Hello children, welcome to the computer class of 6th standard. Today we are going to start with chapter number 6, Scratch Programming, Introduction to Game Creation. In this chapter, we will learn the following topics. We will learn components of Scratch, types of blocks in Scratch, changing the background of the stage, using motion block, the looks block, working with multiple sprites, how to use pen block, how to make a duplicate of the sprite, and how to use sound blocks. Today in this video, we will discuss the following topics from page number 64 and 65. Here we will learn Introduction to Scratch, different features of Scratch, and different components of the Scratch. Before going to start the chapter, let's discuss few key terms that we will learn from page number 64 and 65. Here the first key term is programming language. Here a language is used to write programs is known as programming language. Number two, Scratch, where Scratch is a programming language designed for children to enhance their computing skills. This language is very easy for children to learn and to use. Next is their sprite list. Sprite list displays all the sprites that we have selected. And the last term is sprite info pane, where sprite info pane displays the information of selected sprite. We will also learn the following identifications from page number 65. Here the first identification, you can see a question mark. This is known as block help. Second identification, you can see I is visible. That is sprite info pane. Third one is reverse arrow, that is known as circular arrow. And the last is double headed arrow, which is known as linear arrow. Now open your computer book at page number 64. Chapter number 6, Scratch Programming, Introduction to Game Creation. Here you can see in the first paragraph, the term programming language is given, that I have already explained. And in the second paragraph, the term Scratch is given, that I have already explained earlier. Now here are the few features of the Scratch that we will learn. Number one, it is available free of cost. You can download it from internet at free of cost. Number two, it is easy to understand and learn. Number three, it increases the students' interest in programming. You will see, as you will use this software, you will enjoy to work with it, as we can make different games in this software. Number four, instead of writing text or codes, predefined blocks are snapped together to create the script. The next is there, number five, it allows a playful experimenting with the program segments. Now look at your book at page number 64. Here you can see the components of Scratch. Here you can see in figure 6.1, the components of Scratch window is given, where number one is view full screen. Number two, stage, that is the background area. Number three, sprite. Here you can see an object on the white area, that is known as sprite. Number four, sprite list. Number five, backdrop icon. Number six, menu bar. Number seven, green flag. Number eight, stop button. Number nine, new sprite button. Number 10, title bar. Number 11, cursor tools. Number 12, block help. Number 13, tabs. Number 14, blocks menu. Number 15, script area, and number 16, blocks palette. Now I will explain all these components one by one. Now look at your book at page number 65. Here are the different components of Scratch Windows given. Here the first term is a sprite, where sprites are the object that perform various actions in Scratch project. By default, you will see the cat sprite is selected. Let's do it practically now. First of all, click on Start button. From Start submenu, you need to select the Scratch icon. Here you can see the Scratch icon. Click on this icon and you will get Scratch 2 window on your screen. Now here you can see this object that is appeared on your Scratch window is known as sprite, and by default the cat sprite is selected. Now again look at your book at page number 65. Here the next term is stage, where a stage is the main working area to draw picture or perform actions. It is 480 pixels wide and 360 pixels high, means it is divided into X or Y coordinates, which shows its position of the mouse at the bottom right corner of the stage. Let's see it practically now. Here you can see this white area at the background is known as the stage, where this sprite can perform the actions, and this is divided into X and Y coordinates, and you can see the position of your mouse over here in the corner of the stage. X and Y coordinates are given where you can see the position of your mouse. Now again look at your book at page number 65. Here the next term is given of sprite list, where I have already explained the term sprite list. Let's see it practically now. Now here you can see this gray area below the stage shows you the list of selected sprite. For example, you can see we have by default selected sprite of cat, and the thumbnail of the cat sprite you can see here in this sprite list. Here you can see the next term is block palette, where a block palette contains different predefined blocks that are used to perform specific actions. There are 10 categories of colored coded blocks and 6 different block shapes. Let's say it practically now. Here you can see in your Scratch window this gray area where these different colorful blocks have been appeared is known as the block palette. Here you can see there are 10 different block palettes: motion, looks, sound, pen, data, events, control, sensing, operators, more blocks, and you will also get different 6 shape blocks. Now again look at your book at page number 65. Here the next term is script area. It is the area where we can pick and drop the blocks to create a script, and the stepwise instruction that we give to a sprite to perform is known as the script. Let's see it practically now. Here you can see on the rightmost side of the Scratch window, this gray area is known as the script area. Here you can drag these blocks to make the script. Now again look at your book at page number 65. Here the next key term is given, that is sprite info pane, that I have already explained earlier. This info pane includes a few tools that are sprite rotation style buttons. Here you will see the first button is circular arrow, where this enables the full rotation of the sprite, means you can rotate your sprite in any direction. The next button is linear arrow, where this button enables the sprite to move only to the left or right side. The next button is there, disable rotation. It is like a dot. It disables the rotation, means you can't move your sprite in any direction. The sprite will be remain in the 90 degree. Let's see it practically now. Now here you can see in your Scratch window, below the stage, this sprite list pane will show you the thumbnail of the sprite. By clicking on this eye, you will get the details of this sprite. In the first, you will get the name of the sprite that we can also change as per our choice. Here you can see, by placing the cursor in Sprite 1 name box, press the backspace key from your keyboard and you can type your own name to your sprite. Now, next you can see here the X and Y coordinates that will show you the position of your sprite. In the next, you can see here the direction 90 degree is selected. If you will select the rotation style of the rotation arrow, and if you will select this directions arrow to move your sprite, you can see you can move your sprite in any direction. And if you will select this linear arrow, you can move your sprite only to the left or right side. And if you will select this disable rotation button, then you will see if you will rotate this direction handle, but sprite will not move to any direction. It will continue to face only to the 90 degree. And the next term is there, direction, that I have already explained earlier, that it will rotate your sprite as per given instruction. Till now, we have learned the following key terms from page number 64 and 65. We have learned the key term programming language, Scratch, sprite list, and sprite info pane. We have also learned the following identifications from page number 65. We have learned the identifications of block help, sprite info pane, circular arrow, and linear arrow. Now revise all the terms, step questions, and cross questions till done.